In this video, I, with some help, wire the connections for the NPN normally open proximity sensors, which I'll be using as limit switches, to the Phoenix control board. These switches operate between 6 and 36 volts, and I'm planning to wire a pair of sensors in parallel for both the X and Y axes and a single sensor for the Z axis. My plan is to use the sensors for the X and Y to scan the perimeter of the available cutting area on my CNC machine. My controller uses gerbil and needs an active low signal for these pins, which means the pins will receive a constant 5 volts or a little below and only be active when a transition to zero voltage is applied. So when something metal moves in front of the sensor, the otherwise normally open switch will close, a little red light will turn on the sensor, and the voltage from the signal will drop to zero, letting the controller know the limits have been reached. As I couldn't find proximity sensors which operate with 5 volts or had a controller which could accept a high voltage, I was advised by both the controller's maker, Harry, and Nathan from Opentronic to use voltage dividers to drop the voltage down below the required threshold. There are instructions online as to how to use voltage dividers with the exact same proximity sensor I am using when creating a bed leveling probe for open source 3D printers. These utilize 10 and 15K resistors with a 12V PSU. I thought this would be simple to set up, but I confused myself with a message in a previous video in which I was advised to reduce the resistors by a factor of 10 to prevent problems with interference from the stepper drivers and spindle. I subsequently bought the wrong resistors and have made this part of the project a little harder to edit. I began by fitting a barrier block to one side of the controller, which I can use to secure the cabling from the aviation mount. This has a bit of plastic that can protect the terminals. There's only 6, which means I'll only be able to connect the signals and ground coming in, and then to power the proximity sensors I'll have a cable coming from the 12 volt and then use a small section of terminal like this, maybe inside the cabling or further along. I made sure to solder an extension wire onto the screening on the cables and cut everything to size and crimped forked ends onto the wires I'll be using. I then installed them in the appropriate panel holes. The green and black wires are a little shorter, and those are the signal and ground, while the red is the power. I'm just putting some boot ferrules onto the end of those wires, which I'll then fix into the terminals. I also daisy chained the ground terminals on the barrier block to the ground on the 12 volt power supply unit. So I've just wired the ground to the black wire that's going to the aviation panel mounts, and those in turn go to the blue wire on the proximity sensors. It is really important to make sure all the power supply units are connected so the ground potential between all three are the same. I also checked that these power supply units didn't have floating grounds by testing the connection between the earth and the ground using a voltmeter. So I can use the voltage dividers with the proximity sensors on a 12 volt power supply and the control board on a 24 volt and still use the ground terminals to screen any cabling. So I've just wired an aviation socket mount to one of the proximity sensors. If I haven't made a mistake, the black wire goes to green, the blue wire goes to black, and the red wire goes to brown, which means as I've used an extra bit of wire to connect to the control board, that red is number 4, which is brown, and black is number 3, which is blue, and green is number 2, which is black. I think that makes sense. That's one. What voltage am I getting down there? Have I done this correct? Using the helping hands, I hold the 10K and 15K resistors roughly in place, tin the two areas that will be joined, and finally solder the two wires together. I used heat shrink to cover the exposed wires and label one resistor so I know how to orientate them while installing. The 10K resistor goes to the terminal with the green wire, which is the signal wire from the proximity sensor, and the 15K goes to the terminal connecting the ground from the sensor and the 12 volt power supply. The other thing to mention is you'll need to have the proximity sensors wired and plugged into the aviation panel mounts, otherwise the circuit will not be complete and the voltmeter will read zero after the voltage divider. Okay, I think I need to wire the rest of the proximity sensors just so all the circuits are complete, because it seems to be doing something a little bit weird there. Because I'm still unsure as to how I will manage the cabling from the sensors on my CNC machine, and I know that I want to redesign and recut the plates, I'll just wire a single sensor to each socket so I can test the connections for now. When I do the X, same thing happens, but for some reason if I do the Y, it goes all the way to zero. I was getting some odd results from the voltmeter and naturally began undoing what I had put together, thinking that would identify the problem, but electronics doesn't seem to work like that. I asked Nathan to pop down and use a fresh pair of eyes to help me problem solve.
So this is Nathan from Opentronics. The first thing he...
I'm Opentronic.
He is Opentronic.
Yes.
He looks human, but he's actually a cyborg sent from the future.
Oh, I've got a feeling my life would be a lot easier if I was.
First thing he's noticed is that I wired one of the proximity sensor aviation panel mounts wrong.
I suppose the point with this, though, is that I didn't immediately see that. But I just kept saying to Savas, with what you're describing, like your physical diagram, your physical wiring is not the same as as your electronic diagram for whatever reason. I started measuring the output. So basically what Savas has done is wired the ground of the sensor to here and the output of the sensor to here. And basically we just weren't seeing any output at all. And so the most obvious thing to do then is just follow this whole thing back to the panel. And considering what Savas had been saying about how difficult it is to wire up these aviation sockets, I just thought no output coming from the sensor means
my brain must have sabotaged the process without me realizing.
But then the next strange thing that we've noticed is when I measured the output of the, like when we connected a different sensor, which was in fact wired correctly. So this is the expected behavior of the sensor. So I have that probe on ground, that probe on the output. And when it's not triggered, it's 12. And when it is triggered, it should drop all the way to zero. But then when we connected the voltage divider just now, we were seeing that the overall potential when the voltage divider was connected was something like 7. And at the Arduino it was only 2 volts. And that might have worked for the Arduino's TTL inputs, but it's very peculiar.
I need to get you like a theme song every time you
go
out to the rescue.
Something along the lines of Superman. So I guess, like I was saying before, potentially the Arduino itself is acting like part of a voltage divider,
yeah,
and making a very complicated bottom half of the voltage divider. Because you have these, but again, the circuit diagram isn't complete because these aren't connected to ground.
I mean, I had it all set up like that before. I mean, yeah. I took everything apart just to see what would happen.
Yeah.
I don't know if you can use these to bridge them.
Oh, yeah.
We reconnected all the ground terminals to the 12-volt power supply, but were still getting an unusual reading. Even Nathan was a bit stumped, and I didn't want to take up any more of his time. When he left, I systematically went over all the connections, tightening all the terminals. I added boot ferrules to the end of the voltage dividers, which gave me a little more material to make sure those were securely in place. And once I was sure nothing else was loose, it just started to work.
XYZ. 4.6. Z. 4.6. Y. 4.6. On X. That's really confusing. I think combination of not wiring my panel mounts correctly at the start, and also possibly not connecting something correctly over here, but the voltage dividers seem to be doing what they should be doing. Well, that's something, that's with the voltage divider being triggered on that axis. That one works. That one works as well. What a bloody relief.
It's clearly important to double check your soldering, your crimps, and your terminal connections. Making mistakes is very easy to do, and I seem to make them quite often on this project. But I haven't electrocuted myself yet, so you lot might get a chance to see the end of this.
So the final thing I need to do is again ground the shielding on the limits of the X, the Y, and the Z. And I think I'll leave this as it is for now and get a larger terminal size, the size between this and the larger one. And I'll swap that over just so I can get an extra cable in there. So I'm really thankful to Nathan upstairs and everyone else who's sort of given me some good suggestions along the way. I'm not sure what happened at the end there. The readings weren't coming out as expected. Even Nathan noticed that and didn't quite understand why that was happening. I just tightened everything up and made sure the connections were okay. Obviously I made the mistake of wiring one of my proximity sensors panel mount sockets incorrectly, but it seems to be working now, and that's a relief. That's, I think this is my new catchphrase for this series of videos. Welcome to the end of another episode of how to nearly electrocute yourself and destroy your equipment while making a CNC machine. That was a relief.